Hi everybody, I'm going to do a little test video here of drawing a dinosaur. The dinosaur that I'm going to choose today is the Hadrosaurus, one of the first known and discovered dinosaurs. It actually doesn't even have a skull, so a lot of representations of it are actually a lot of guesswork. So what I'm using right now is a picture. Let me see if I can get to you. I just did a Google image search. And I'm just using a couple of things, but mostly I'm looking at these skeletons. Because when I'm drawing dinosaurs, I do like to try and get the skeletal structure there first. It's not something you have to do, it's not something that's important. I just think with dinosaurs, it's kind of neat because all that we have left of them are their fossils. So, you know, that's really all we have to go by. So, you know, it has its spine going on the back here. Probably didn't have a frill. There's no evidence to support that it had a horn like some of the other members of the Hadrosaur family, but you know. What I actually like to do with the Hadrosaur is because there was no head found for it, in order to relate it to also some modern day animals, I like to give it this collar right here, like you see on ducks. I'm just using a normal, you know, number two pencil here. And right now I'm actually looking at the camera, which is my phone, rather than the paper. So this is going to be interesting just to see how this comes out in general. One of the other interesting things about the Hadrosaurs, there's not really much evidence, well, Hadrosaurs in general, it's a little bit debated whether they walked on 4 feet, like a quadruped, like a horse or anything else, or on 2 feet, bipedal. Most any media shows them using a combination of both. The Hadrosaur, for the most part, seems like any pictures that I find of it would just be on its plane 4 feet, which is kind of what we're going with here. There's also always the debate whether or not, alright, so this has kind of a little bit of a longer neck, kind of messed that up a little bit, but the nice thing about working with pencil and art and just practicing, I'm just doing this for fun. And if anybody wants to watch a video of some guy drawing a dinosaur to the best of his limited ability, that's great. If not, you don't have to, that's fine. The feet are kind of hooved a little bit too. Well, hooves is not the right word, but they have longer sprawling toes. Well, his hooves are actually toes, but that's besides the point. Their body structure tends to go up a little bit, their hips being a little bit higher, which I guess would support more of a bipedal creature. That's my dog destroying my couch in the background. If you hear that scratching. Sharp of a turn. You don't want the neck to go up like that and the body to start to go like that. Proportions are a little bit off, but again, that's okay. Toes that I'm starting with, it almost remind me of like a, in the stance in general, actually, almost kind of reminds me of a frog. I don't think I'm intentionally doing that, but. That structure. Feathers or scales? I kind of like to do a combination of both. Although most hadrosaurs probably just have scales. But it would kind of be nice, definitely. I always like to add, but I always think they like to think they always have bright colors. A little bit of a fluffy tail going along here towards the end. Birds always tend to have scaly legs. I'd like to think, especially again when I try to relate them to modern birds. I tend to like to give them a very similar feature. Let's see. A duck has a bill. Obviously, this is a duck-billed dinosaur. So. Also wind up keeping that orange. Right. Yeah, this is fun. Coming up on 8 minutes. Well, it doesn't really look like this one's foraging too much. Maybe, let's see, is it in a defensive stance? A little background here. Is there a nest? What are we doing here? Obviously it's daytime. Shadow on the ground here. Alright. Cool. An ant. Alright. Well. is something I'll start to develop a little bit further. With my artwork, I always like to try and keep it sketchy. For me, when the art is a little bit more sketchy, it allows different people to see what they want to see, instead of making it something so very defined. So, like, this could be feathers to some people, or it could kind of just be like a little hump on the back, maybe a little frill. Could be a little bit more scaly here, could not be. Could be more of a beak or not. I don't know if I love that hair on the top. So, it's either hair on the top, or maybe it's more ridge. Maybe it is, maybe it's not. Define it a little bit more. Let's go crazy. So the intention here is for this to be a little baby hadrosaur. That's it. Guess I'll do a little signature here. I'm trying to take the paper down. Okay. I'm not exactly sure what I'm doing with this, but here we go. Here's a hadrosaur for fun.